Hello, I am Mal, and welcome back to Wasteland 2. Alright, we continue here in Prison Valley. We're heading back over to the prison to deal with Commander Danforth, but before that, I wanted to give you guys a close look here at this cool artwork that they put in for this car. One of my longtime subscribers, Bruno, who of course inspired this character here, wanted to take a look at it, so there you go, Bruno. There it is in all of its glory. There doesn't seem to be any way to interact with it or anything. I tried mechanical repair and other things, but it's just a piece of artwork. But it does look cool. So, yeah. Thought you'd want to see that. Who knows, somebody will, maybe later on, once there's mod support, maybe somebody will put it in, you know, that you actually could, you know, get the car. That would be neat. I already got that toaster. Yep. Alright, let's head to the prison. Now, I don't know, maybe I wasn't clear, but let me try to be very, very clear here. First things first, Commander Danforth and the RSM are going to die. That's going to happen. Now, something else to note is that I set along a series of events, a chain reaction, so to speak. Because if you remember way back earlier in the playthrough, I let those pigs escape at the big farm, and I ended up in that fight that I wasn't ready for, and I actually almost got killed. That was one of the few times I was not prepared for a fight. It hurt pretty badly. Now, the repercussion from that was that since we did all of that at the farm and killed all those RSM guys, Danforth's response to that was to send out these hit squads. You know, the people there were killed, the farmers whose pigs had been stolen, you know, I showed you that in the last episode, they had been killed, and others have as well. So, there's no peaceful resolution with Danforth, for me, you know, for this playthrough. However, there is a peaceful resolution solution. Say that 10 times real fast. There is a peaceful resolution solution to the Commander Danforth and RSM, quest line, if you so choose. Okay? Now, I think they're a bunch of scumbags, so that's not my choice, but you certainly could if you want to. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you one of the ways that you can get into the prison without using the track on the robot, the piece that we recovered from the Tinkerer's place. Let me show you that again. So here's the tank tread. Okay, now this piece right here you can use to repair the little robots outside of the gates at the prison. And it'll go up and it'll deal with the turrets for you. And I'll show you that in more detail. But that's essentially one way to handle it. You can repair the robot, send the robot in, and then there's a couple more things that you have to do, but you can get into the prison. Okay, that's one way. Another way is, since we've been gone and all this has gone down and things have happened, Job, the guy that we met up at the Atwater farm, he actually poisoned all of Danforth's dogs. That was that long rambling bit that Danforth did over the radio towards Vargas in the last episode. So his dogs are sick, and Job will give you the antidote, because he doesn't really want the dogs to die, he just wants Danforth to die. So you can go up, you can talk on the intercom, you can say you've got the antidote, and then you can go in to the prison, and you can deal with Danforth. You can still kill Danforth. And I think you might actually be able to save the dogs. I'm not 100% sure on that one. But that's another way that you can get in there. And there may even be more ways, but I know that those are certainly the ways. So you've got use the robot, you've got offer to give the antidote. You can also kind of brute force your way through, though I don't recommend that. And again, you can choose to kill Danforth and his guys, or ultimately there is, a way to talk your way through it type thing after you heal up the dogs. Alright, so, having said all that, let's move forward. I've obviously cleared everything out here, so we can just sort of run through. We'll head up top here towards the prison. And what I think I'll do is I will actually cut in. Yeah, that's what I'll do. I have a previous video. I'm going to cut in the, or likely what I'm going to do is I'll cut in the video portion from the old video showing how to use the tank tread and that route. And then in this playthrough, I'll go ahead and play through trying to use the antidote route so that you guys can actually see both without having to go back and look at an old video. All right, so here's Job. Let's talk to you. Or let's talk to him. He's saying you. All right, what up, Job? It's all your fault, Rangers. If you'd finished off the Red Scorpions like I told you, this never would have... Yeah, I know. I'm the one who made the dog sick, and I told the Scorpions the Rangers were the ones who did it. It's the only way I could think of to make you finish Danforth like I told you. Make us? I tried to appeal to your pity, but you didn't listen. How'd you make him sick? There was a plague. Blisterpaw, it's called. I've seen some wild dogs with it in the scrub? Yeah, in the scrub, so I caught one and brought it to the farm. Poor guard dogs, it spread so quick. I was going to cure them as soon as you and the Scorpion started fighting, but I realized that if I did, Danforth would guess it was me who infected them, and I was too afraid. Then my plan didn't even work. The Rangers were supposed to kick Danforth's ass, but he's kicking yours. Now the Scorpions are going to rule everywhere. Whatever. Do you have the cure? Yes, but I can't give it to the dogs. Commander Danforth will kill me as soon as I do. We did try to finish him. We couldn't get past the tourists. Well, you could have told me. Would have never tricked him into attacking you. You need to cure the dogs and confess to Danforth. But Danforth loves those dogs. You have to protect me. We'll cover you. Just give us the cure and we'll take it to him. Alright, so let's do this. Alright, let's head over towards the actual prison, which is over here. And let's see what the logbook actually said. Job gave us the cure for the dog plague and asked us to cure the dogs in the prison. We promised we wouldn't mention it was him who started the plague. Come on, get over there. Run! Run! Run, slackers. What did he say? Danger, trespassing, strongly worded warning. I love the way that guy talks. It's awesome. Okay, let's soup up Vax, because shortly here we will be fighting. Oh, we will be fighting. Alright, so let me come up here. Okay, so there's the little robot. Again, I think what I'll do is I'll cut in the video for you so that you can see how to get into this portion. Of the prison, because you have to deal with turrets here and here, and then there's a whole series of landmines over here, like a ton of them. So again, I'm going to go ahead, I'll cut in the part of the other video that shows you that. You guys can watch that, and then, or not, optionally, of course, and then come back to this point right here. And I will go for the let's talk to him thing and kind of talk our way into the prison, and then we'll kill him once we're in there. Okay? So, I'll see you in just a sec. Alright, so we're going to take a look here at option one, which is utilizing the little robot by the gate here to go in and deal with the turrets. So, what you'll need to do first is repair it using the tank tread that you received at the Tinkerer's place in Demonta. As you can see here, I have a character doing that. And then once you do that, you interact with the robot and select 2 for inorganic. And then it's going to send the little robot out to deal with the turrets. So you can see here he goes. Goes up to the turrets and I don't know how he blows them up, but he does. Then you're going to have to deal with... in the section right here, you'll have to do a perception check. You need at least a 6. And then probably like a 6 or 7 demolition skill. You'll need to deactivate all of the landmines or have someone that can tank that damage. So you could do it a couple different ways. Obviously, the easiest way would be to use demolition skills to disarm all of the multitude, as you can see here, of landmines that go all the way through. It's sort of ridiculous how many there are. But once you've disarmed those, you can head inside. And then once inside, what I did and worked out fairly well is I just sort of set myself up in sort of a semicircle along the edge of the first building. And then I could take shots on the people that were up on the rooftops to the right, and I could kind of weed them out a little bit. Now, the footage that you're seeing here is from back in the beta, and what I will tell you is that the release version of this fight I found to be much more challenging. Of course, on the release fight, though, I am doing it on Ranger difficulty, as you'll see in a moment, so that sort of does change things. But trying to get the best positioning that you can, and that you learn from what is actually, honestly, not the best positioning on my part in the next segment of the video. I could have done a little bit of a better job, I think, setting up. But for this one, it's pretty simple. I just set up a semicircle here, and then I start the fight. So this is option one, utilizing the robot and then demolition skill to get into the actual prison. And then all you have to do once you've set up your people is just initiate combat from back here. You don't talk to Danforth. You don't expose any of your rangers to any potential additional damage. The second option of, you know, quote unquote curing the dogs is that you actually have to put at least one soldier within range to initiate the conversation with Danforth, as you'll see here shortly. And that kind of changes the dynamic a little bit. I would say that this way of just sort of utilizing the robot and then going in is easier. All right, now we're going to look at the second way of getting into the prison, which is promising to cure Danforth's dogs.
So, the dog killers have returned across the line of stones, Rangers. I'm begging you.
We're not dog killers. We have a cure for your dogs.
No bullshit? I don't believe it. All right, Rangers. I ain't gonna turn down a chance to cure my dogs. But if you're lying to us, you're dead. Hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. Oh, hello, turrets. You know what? Can we? No, can't reach them, huh? He's like, can we hack them? Okay, so no landmines if you've talked your way in. They're remote-controlled landmines, apparently, that they could deactivate. Well, I guess logically what you would say is that they tell you that they're there or something, or who knows. Alright, now, we need to set up for this fight. So we're only going to send one person forward to talk. Probably Ralphie? Yeah, he's got the most hit points. Well, or he has the most hit points and doesn't have medical skills. Yeah, because I'm not going to send Christy up there. That's not a good idea. So, we'll set up back here. Or can we actually get on some buildings or something? No, not really. Well, yeah, actually, no. If we go up here, we'll end up interacting with him, is my guess. So, alright, let's go like this. Yep, we'll go like that. We'll deal with these guys in stages. That's my plan, anyway. We'll see how this works out. Lex, you can just sort of hang out right there, buddy. Anton, right here. Okay, let's grab Ralphie. Ralphie's gonna go up, sort of talk to them, and then run away, basically. Okay. Okay, a tall, a tall, hard-eyed man with a purple scar across his clean-cut left cheek. The hate in his eyes looks hot enough to burn you to the ground. Oh, is that right? Well, he's a colonel. Colonel Thurman Campbell, huh? I would dearly love to cut you up and feed you to our dogs, but if they really have a cure, then stand right there and you wait. The boss is coming. If you don't have a cure, then make a move. It'll be your last. Oh, is that right? Is that right? Yeah, I got the cure. You
Come
better.
On, Arena. You can make it, girl. I want you to see the man who did this to you. And then, I'll kill them. So, Rangers, they tell me you can cure my dogs. Can you raise the dead ones, too? Can you bring Rex back to me?
Who's Rex? Alright, so... Wow. Let me tell you this little story. Once upon a time, a boy and his dog lived in Highpool, and one day the Rangers came to town and killed the dog. So that happened in the first game. There was a dog that, you know, basically had gone crazy, it had rabies, and you had to put it down. And then, unfortunately, you had to kill Bobby, his owner, this kid. But this is Bobby, all grown up. I guess he got out, I guess he clung to life and managed to get out of, you know, the situation, and then, I don't know, I guess left Highpool, because they thought he was dead. Any wonder that that little boy clawed his way back from the edge of the grave? He vowed to hurt the Desert Rangers worse than they had hurt him. Any wonder that he started the biggest, baddest gang in the land and made the Desert Rangers their public enemy number one? Your gang are simple raiders. We're militia now, Ranger, the law in these parts, and pretty soon we're going to be the law in all of Arizona. My dream has always been to show you effing cowboy tyrants how to do peacekeeping right, treat the people with respect, not kill their children. By taxing them to death and enslaving them on your farm? We're in a transition. I'm getting rid of the bad apples as quick as I can. Yeah, right. Have you asked them if they, you know, want that deal there, dude? Sometimes people don't know what's best for them. Sometimes you have to force them into good decisions. Oh, you have to force them into good decisions. Wow, okay. Is that right? Let's see. If the Rangers forced you to work on a farm, would you have thanked us? That's different. The Rangers are a bunch of dog-killing bullies who don't care what happens to the little people. Alright, I don't have a level 6 smartass, so I can't do any more of that. But, let me guess, you're Bobby. Yeah, it only took you 15 years. Give the Ranger a cigar. Now see if you can guess the size of the hole I'm going to put in your head. Agree to make peace with the Rangers and kill your dog. Okay, so I'm not going to do that. Okay, so at this point, I've talked my way in here, which is really all I wanted to do with this... with this line. Now, I am guessing, and that's all it is, but I do guess or surmise that if you do this, this would be, in theory, lead you to the peaceful, quote-unquote, peaceful resolution with the RSM. And I think you could probably, knowing that this is Bobby and what had happened, I don't think it's not okay that he had people in his organization like Pitbull that was... you know, had women forcibly, you know, as essentially sex slaves and people they had killed and extorted or whatever. It doesn't make it okay. But Danforth is a little bit more of a sympathetic character now that you know that he's Bobby. In my opinion, I think it's kind of cool how they tied events to the first game into the second. And even if you didn't play the first game, they did a pretty decent job between the interactions in Highpool and then here explaining what happened. And how that could, you know, that could traumatize a kid, right? Come in, you're almost killed by the Rangers, they kill your dog, they leave. I mean, it's like a bad country song, right? Okay, so we're going to say no, goodbye, or whatever here, which I think is going to initiate combat. We're already set up back there. Hopefully Ralphie's tough enough that he can take a few shots up front. All right, here we go. Yeah, we're done here. Yeah, combat. All right, that's what I thought was going to happen. Wow, lots of them are getting to attack before I get to do anything. Oof. Alright, let's move Lex up here, if nothing else, potentially draw a little bit of fire. And spread it out a bit. Out of range. Blocked sight. Okay. I guess we're going for this guy. Hi there. Man, this is not ideal here. So if Ralphie's still standing here in a couple of seconds, then I'm gonna be using... There we go. Okay, explosives time. Yep, right here. Hi! How you doing? Yeah, that should hit them all. Should be good damage. Actually, how many hit points do these guys have? Hold on. Swap weapons. 70, 45, 80. Don't I have something smaller I could use? Nah, I didn't bring it along. Well, pipe bomb. No, pipe bomb does 50. Grenade? Could do a grenade. Yeah. It should be enough. Do they have armor? You know what? Let me double check. No, no armor. Two armor. One. One. Well, a grenade in theory should do it, so let's try that. Hi! It did, but it also killed the dog. Aw, man. But it killed the dog. I don't know if I would have been able to still cure the dog or not, which was kind of my plan. But that might have gotten cut off when we initiated combat anyway, so I'm not really sure. Yeah, let's go to cover here. At least some cover. Ow. Okay, Ralphie might be going down here. Whew. Okay, we gotta move up here. We gotta get some people in range. Sight blocked, sight blocked. Guess we can finish this guy. Oh no, we can hit downstream here. Alright. Okay, let's take out that guy. Okay, in turn. Alright, I guess let's move up here. Get him, Vax! There we go. A little bit of damage. Okay, let's run up. Yeah, this didn't work out as well as I thought it would. The whole moving up deal. Okay, let's smack this guy. There we go. Nice. Or the, you know, having these guys back here, that didn't work so well. Alright, we'll go up here and take these cover points. Yeah, Ralphie's gonna go down. There's nothing I can do about that. I'll just have to hope he doesn't get killed and then patch him up after the fact. Oh, actually, no, he's still alive. Alright, well, we could use a dirty grenade. Haven't used those yet. Something like this. Yeah, let's do that. How you doing? This guy get irradiated? No, I guess they, if you're up top on a different level, you're not affected unless I drop it directly up top, even though they were highlighted. That's kind of lame. All right, well, let's get behind cover. Oh, we actually have the ability to shoot some people? No, sight blocked on all of those. Alright, well, how about here? Same thing? Yep, sight blocked. Okay, switch. Alright, let's light this guy up. There we go, jammed. Yeah. That's the value in this other weapon. As someone pointed out, I think it was Bruno. 0% chance to jam, I guess, is the Big Betty's big value. Yeah. So, but it does use the more expensive ammo, so kind of a balance. Well, maybe they were affected by it, I don't know. This guy's just firing like crazy. Alright, dude. Hey, quit shooting Vax! If I lose Vax, I'm gonna be upset. For real. Alright, let's go for this guy. Okay, that was pretty decent. Headshot? No, we already have 40% crit. There's no reason to. Let's go for this one. And this guy has 4 hit points left, huh? Alright, I'm actually gonna move back with her. Could I hit that guy? Maybe. But I'm going to be awfully exposed. Let's grab one of these. Mm-hmm. Radiated friendly fire. What? He wasn't highlighted? Come on. Well, gotta live with it. What is that? Better what? Better red than ranger? That's kinda funny. Let's see. I guess we can go put Lex like right up in their face. Actually, no. Let's not. Let's just go like this, set ambush. Alright, we're okay. Bruno, move over here. Okay, no longer in the radiated status. Okay, good. I guess if you move out of the radiation cloud here, then immediately you're okay. Which makes zero sense whatsoever, but I'm okay with it. This guy or this guy? That's the shotgunner guy, and they're side by side here. Okay, let's take him out. There we go. That definitely could have handled this fight better, there's no doubt about it. I thought my strategy of setting up in the back, you know, was going to work well, but ultimately it didn't. Let's see. Throw another dirty grenade? No. I think we need to use some actual, like, damage dealing stuff here. And I have a very awkward positioning here for this. How much health does this guy have? 30? And how much damage does this thing do? 50? Okay, so that should take him out. Alright. Well, let's do that. There we go. Dead guy. And let's swap weapons. I don't want to spend a turn reloading. Can we see these guys? No, we can't. That's really problematic. Can we hit someone else with the Gamma Ray Blaster? Yes, we can. Alright, let's finish this guy then. Actually, these guys have heavy armor. Let me go for that guy. Melted! You gotta love that. So awesome. Oh, and we lost Vax. Oh, that sucks. Alright, well, it was bound to happen eventually. He runs forward. Let's see. Single shot? No, that's not gonna get her done. Right here. Get him. Nice! Oh, his head popped off. Oh, that's fun. And then is there someone we can, like, with a little bit of health left we can finish off? Yes, this guy. There we go. And let's put some work in over here. Here we go. And then we'll move back a little more. Swap. Can we maybe get a decent shot from over here? Yes, we can. Crouch. Take a single shot. There we go. Now we're making some progress. Do I want to move forward here? Yeah, I could come over here. I'll have cover. I can take this guy out? Oh, this is a named NPC, huh? Interesting. Yeah. Huh. Shouldn't he fall off the building? What do you think? That's kind of interesting. That's funny. Okay, sorry. I just thought that was funny. Let's see here. Back it up here. Intern? Ralphie's going down. Yep. Oh, no, not Ralphie! It's been a while since Ralphie's taken a dirt nap like that. But it's fine. He's in no risk of dying. We're good. Alright, this guy's gonna turn into purple goo. Melted! Okay, can Lex... No, Lex can't get a hit there, so we'll just set the ambush. Okay, swap weapons. Come on. There we go. Really? Pretty long way to throw that thing, dude. Let's see. Oh, I guess this is her only target? Yep, alright. Oh, I'm sorry, his only target. My bad. Here we go. Move up to here. Nope, can't take a shot. Alright, set ambush. Finish this guy off. Okay, in turn. Sight blocked. I could move. I don't think so. I think I'll switch to a single shot, set ambush. And move over here with Lex, I guess. Is there someone else over here, or is that one guy the last dude? I thought there was a guy over here. Alright, can we kill this one? Come on, hit him. There we go. Yeah, there's still a guy. Where is he? Back here somewhere? Alright. Let's move everyone up then. Yeah, move over here. Is this guy gonna come towards us? That would make things a lot simpler. Okay, in turn. We need to reload. Okay, let's do that. And set ambush. Gamma ray blaster. You know what? Let's go over here, and then next turn we can patch up Ralphie. I think that makes sense. Oh, there's more of them, huh? Alright. So be it. Let's head up here. It's a good cover spot. Okay, bring up Vulture's Cry. And... yeah, let's just keep pushing forward, I guess. Yeah, they're coming around. Oh, alright, this guy's really helping us out. Svargus Snake? Instead of Snake Vargas? Okay, was this a cousin? Weapon jam. Sucks to be you, pal. There we go, still have cover. And let's push up over here. Let's patch up Ralphie. Go ahead and use one of these advanced trauma kits. Well, actually, no, I don't need to. I was going to say I'd use an advanced trauma kit because I have so many, but what's the point? I don't really need to. Okay, are we in range? Sight blocked. Alright, then we'll run up over here. Likewise, come over to here. This guy's gonna have a bad time. As soon as we've got an angle on him, that is. Where do we want to put you at? I don't really want to just put you out in the open to get shot. How about right here? That looks good. Set ambush. And Ralphie's back on his feet. What's up, pal? What's he got? What's that said? Oh, nauseous. Well, that's fine. I'm not gonna have him do anything anyway. So it's all good. Get him! Okay, swap. In turn. This should do it here. That's it. Wow, 990 XP. Holy crap. That's a lot of XP. Wow. Okay, now, do we actually have something I'm not sure about? Is do we actually have a cure? You know, for the dogs or whatever? Because there's kennels or something back here, if I remember correctly. Yeah. I'm not certain. Let me take a look here. Or was it just... Because sometimes, you know, with quest stuff, they just speak to it like, oh yeah, you have the cure, but you don't actually not actually carry... Oh, dog plague cure. Okay. Well, let me do a little bit of healing here, just in case we run into more problems. And then we can try to go cure any of the other dogs that there are. I mean, it's not the dog's fault they got poisoned. It's not their fault that they're guard dogs, right? Another one here. I don't want to waste too many medical supplies because I think we're probably done with conflict over here and we can get free healing at multiple places. Oh, let's call in for these promotions.
Copy, Echo One. Echo One, congratulations.
I think we have another attribute point. We do. Okay. Now. Probably into awareness to raise his combat initiative. Yeah, I'm thinking that's where it's gonna go. But you guys always give me your thoughts on this stuff, so I'm asking. I'm thinking awareness. But let me know what you think. And then for skills... You know, the social skill stuff, I've been kind of disappointed with. I don't think I'm going to invest any more money in that, or any more skill points in that. Leadership. I might do that. It's either going to go into leadership or assault rifles. You could argue leadership is superior because it's going to give a 2% increase to hit for everyone. Instead of a 7, so it's 7% chance base hit increase for him if I go with assault rifles, or a 2% increase for everyone. That's kind of a tough call, actually. I'll commit it for now. Nothing here. Nothing more to do there right now. Okay. So let's see if we can find these dogs. I'll loot all this stuff that's here off camera. Okay, so there's kennels back here. Yeah. Okay, that's to converse with them. Can I just use the cure item? Can try. Yeah, it seems to be working. Yeah, okay. Well, let's just cure him. Oh, but then we have to fight him? Oh, that's not good. I don't want to fight the dogs. I don't want to fight the dogs. Really? You're making me fight the dogs? Okay. You can talk to him. Whimper. I mean, there's nothing. What am I gonna do here? Can I? Is there like a food source or something I can treat? No. I mean, I guess that makes sense that they would have to administer the cure. Yeah. So I guess you can't really save the dogs, unfortunately. All right, let's go talk to Job real quick, and then I'll come back in off camera and loot the stuff off the bodies and go sell it and do all that stuff. And then we'll be headed back to the Ranger Citadel. But we should have quest complete from Job. That should give us some more experience. Are these turrets going to attack us? No, they didn't. Okay. Job's going to be back here towards the farm, I guess. Or at the farm. Job, where are you, buddy? Why are you hiding? No, he's actually standing in the same place in the road. I guess he did have other things to do. He's probably going to be upset about the dogs. So you did it? Did you cure the dogs? It? We didn't cure the dogs, but Danforth is dead. Your farm is yours again. Really? Oh my god, I thought this day would never come. Thank you, Rangers. You saved my life. You saved this community. Well, alright. So that's done. Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, please hit that thumbs up button. As always, I appreciate your comments and feedback. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, I'm Mal, and I will see you later.